हेलो स्टूडेंट, मायसेल्फ इज अश्विनी कुमार पाठक फ्रॉम लक्ष्मी प्रसाद मेमोरियल पब्लिक स्कूल गोला बाजार। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द कंप्यूटर मेमोरी एंड इट इज़ ए वेरी एसेंशियल पार्ट ऑफ द कंप्यूटर वर्ल्ड थ्रू विच ए कंप्यूटर वर्क्स इफिशियंटली। सो यू शुड नो दैट द स्मॉलेस्ट यूनिट ऑफ द कंप्यूटर मेमोरी इज बिट and we will discuss about it in a very wide range. So first let's start, we will try to understand what is the memory first thing. So without memory nobody can do anything or anywhere. So memory is an important thing that we should keep in our mind, and the same thing is applied to the computer also. So without memory a computer is useless. So we have to give some kind of instruction, information or data to a computer to work efficiently. So let's start what is the computer memory. First thing, there are two types of computer memory. First one is the primary memory and second one is the secondary memory. So these two types of memory, combination of the two types of the memory, make a computer to work efficiently. So first we will talk about the primary memory. Primary memory is very very essential, because when we start up a computer, so the first thing, whatever is loaded in the computer hard disk, it use primary memory to start up a computer, and with the help of this your operating system gets started. So let's start. First one is the RAM. RAM is just like a blackboard or a calculator. So in the RAM means random access memory. And there is another ROM, R-O-M, read only memory. So RAM, whatever you use to write or feed the data into the computer, gets inside the memory. It with the help of RAM, it works until that time when we switch off the computer, the memory used to lose, because it is versatile memory, and so we cannot put more data into this because its capacity is limited. So after saving a data into the computer, it goes to the hard disk or to the secondary memory. And second thing that we have to talk about is that when we turn off the computer, the information and data stored in random access memory is lost. When a computer starts, the operating system begins loading into RAM. Any software that runs on a computer also gets loaded into RAM. It is called random access memory. For CPU access, the memory in a random manner. It is also called read and write memory, because information can be read from it and data can also be written or stored on it. So RAM is a volatile memory, which means it loses its data once the power is turned off. Why read only memory? Here the ROM is classified into three categories. First one is the PROM, second is EPROM, and third one is the EPROM. So let's try what is the ROM. ROM means read only memory. So it is a type of memory which you can only read the information stored in it but cannot write on it. That means the instruction
stored in Rome cannot be changed. The information is permanently stored in it. Data and instruction stored in Rome are not lost even when the power is turned off. Therefore, it is known as non-volatile memory. And second thing, we are talking about the ROM. So first come the, what is PROM? PROM is nothing but the content of the memory can be modified by a programmer only once. In the PROM, the programmer can change the data only once, not more than one. Second thing is EPROM. EPROM is the, this is a programmer read only memory, data can be erased and rewritten on it. And the third one is EEPROM. This is a programmable read only memory on which data can be erased or rewritten using an electrical charge. So by giving an electrical charge, we can rephrase the read-only memory. Now, as you may be knowing that the storage capacity of the primary memory is limited. So, whatever we feed into the computer, it goes to the secondary memory. And secondary memory, there are a lot of the storage capacity devices like hard disk, CD, DVD, Blu-ray disc and pen drive. With the help of all these things, we can store a large amount of data. Suppose primary memory has limited capacity, so you need some additional storage devices to store the data. These storage devices are called secondary memory. Secondary memory is also known as external or auxiliary memory. The data stored in the external memory is not lost even when the computer is turned off. The CPU cannot access it directly because it is an external memory. Contents of secondary memory are first transferred to primary memory and then CPU can access it. This is the reason why secondary memory is slower than primary memory. Secondary memory is non-volatile in nature. Some example of secondary memory storage devices are given over here, like hard disk, CD, DVD, Blu-ray disc and pen drive. So we can classify the memory units into bit. The group of 8 bit is equal to 1 byte. So there are a lot of the measurement. With the help of that, we can measure the memory capacity of a computer very properly. And in the next section, when I will teach you different memory units, so you will know what are the different memory units. So until that, just understand, try to understand what is the primary memory, as I have explained you over here, and the second memory. So primary memory is volatile in nature, and secondary memory is not volatile in nature. That means when the power is off, the program, whatever you have data written, get erased. But in secondary memory, even after the power gets off, the memory get intact into that. So it is called to be the non-volatile nature of the memory. So our next session will be based on the memory unit. So next time we will learn more thing about the memory you have.
I hope that you have understood it very well, the differences between the primary memory and the secondary memory. So it is, we can say that without memory, nothing is possible in the world to understand or to understand and carry out a work properly. So I hope that you have understood it very well, and in the next session we will discuss upon the memory units. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.